Welcome back, friends, to episode 2 in our Oathtakers Expert Low Ironman campaign. Let's see what we got going on. Obituary. Nobody has died. That's shocking. All right, so we got this guy. Kind of a marginal militia. This is our best guy, the Oathtaker. This is a decent gravedigger we picked up. Not a very good manhunter. This wild man has like 130 something fatigue. He's crazy. This guy sucks. He's a flagellant. He's got very low HP. He's also injured right now. Just picked up this guy. Nothing special about him. And here's our Bannerman, the other Oathtaker. So we got a bunch of good equipment. You can see we have some nice armor now. Could use some better helmets. Actually, I think that guy has that because he's injured. So we just finished a caravan mission, and I was going to head back down south and try and do the arena again. Sometimes in the early game, you can find nomad camps that are pretty easy. Alright, two nachos. We just won that fight, so we should be able to do it again. Our wild man, this guy, and this guy. Giving this guy a little bit less armor, just so he has more fatigue. Okay, our wild man can take. He's got enough. Actually, you know what? That should be fine. Alright, the only problem is, this guy's probably going to eat our guy. So we're going to have to kill him with these two guys. Okay, got a little lucky there. That didn't go as well as the last one. Give him rally the troops so we can fight Geists. Try the day tailor for 90. Okay, he's just trash. Looks like there is probably another city-state to the right over here, so I think I'm just gonna see if there's any camps around here that are not too bad. Go back and try and do the arena again. Okay, same fight. I'm going to wait with my guys because I want them to lose initiative so that these guys act before us. Okay, that's good. Not bad. Could try this peddler for 100. He's just absolute garbage. So we're doing pretty well in the arena. I think maybe I'll head west, hit the other city state. See if we can get anything relevant over there, contracts or whatnot. Be strong enough to fight legionaries. Okay, that's a good fight for us. Thank you. just going to get rid of these guys so we don't level up people that are just absolute trash. Alright, the wild man can take that. Okay, this guy is no longer injured, our flagellant. I think we can probably move this guy into the front now. Trying to give guys better shields without impeding their stand too much. A lot of times when I fight in the desert, I just move up 3 instead of 4. Because when you move up 3, it costs 18 fatigue. So it's almost kind of like you're stam neutral after you recover the 15 fatigue for next turn. Whereas if I move up 4, by the time I actually get there, my guys are going to be fatigued. Got 11 range defense. It's not like he has nothing. I mean, guy's almost stammed out, and he doesn't have any armor, and he's important. So I think I'm going to leave him there for now. So this is not going well, if you haven't noticed. Took a lot more damage there than I would have liked, but you know, our guys are pretty bad at this point. We haven't really taken a lot of fights as a company, so I kind of forgot how bad our guys are. It's not a bad price for that Lintho Rax. 117. I think I'll grab that. Getting good prices here, so let's sell stuff. Let's take a look at some of these other guys here. This guy's 100. Let's try him. Good background, 730. It's a little pricey. 850's pricey. Okay, I mean, this guy's serviceable. Be nice to have more pole arms. I think we're gonna have to move this guy into the front now. Because he has 68 HP. See, we need better helmets too. I don't want to spend the money on these other guys. $730, that's not bad for $730, but we don't have. What does this guy have for melee defense? 20? Could maybe give the Wild Man this cleaver. So I think that seems like a reasonable plan. So let's grab this guy for 730. Pretty disappointing for an anatomist. 57 is not very good. Low starting stats, but he has talents. I'm just going to give him a D. Decent armor for the company. Well, we're going to have to give this guy good armor if he's going to do that, because he only has 5 melee defense. just gonna camp for a little bit. Our armor is pretty banged up. Taking the fight at night is going to be to our advantage. Okay, so there's only six of them. Definitely not an easy fight, though. Necromancer with five wider gangers. Just gonna move up two. I'm gonna try and flank with this guy, the Wild Man. I don't think we need to adrenaline with him. So he's gonna bleed out. He's dead. Necromancer. pretty good fight. Alright, I think it's probably time to get out of the south. Reason being, I want to get better recruits, and generally the recruits are better in the north or the middle of the map. My opinion. Just trying to decide if maybe we could buy some of these, a bunch of these trade goods and sell them. So we have to go to Film Zoos, which is up here. So I think I will take that contract. Established village. So we don't know where any of the cities are. We haven't found any cities. Vardistad is a city, but they're hostile to us. So that to me makes these trade goods less attractive. Plus the prices are a little bit higher. So I don't know that we would make a lot of money trying to flip those. I think we'll just buy some tools. We could buy another Lintharax here. Not much better than what we have, but we are going to want to hire more people, so I think I'll grab it. And I'm not going to get any more tools because I want to have enough money to hire people. Maybe we can buy one more set of tools. Unfortunately, we didn't find a lot of contracts in the south. So, I feel like normally the south is better than that. Some outlaws and some archers. Four to six outlaws, four to six archers. I think that might be a little bit too much for us to handle at this point. few Orc Young and a few Berserkers. Alright, I want to take that fight. Even if we lose some people, if we could get some orc weapons, all right, that's what I'm looking for. I don't know if we can win this though. This is pretty intense here for this company. What I'm going to do right now is retreat and then go to that town, try and get some more people, and then come back. And we can just sacrifice some of the newer guys that are crappy to try and get some of these weapons. That's another good fight I would have liked to have taken. Okay, step to the west. He's good. Let's get one more guy here. Let's try the flagellant. Okay, he's got 39 HP. I don't know that a tailor is really going to be much better, so I think I'm just going to save my money. Let's just try and equip our guys now that we have two new people here. Crappy helmets. It's going to be tough for us to take this fight clean, but I want to try. Can try to tank with this guy. 32, he's got this shield, has a lot of durability. That's probably our best option for tanking. would have been nice having more guys with adrenaline. That was kind of what we needed here. I think I'm just going to leave everybody here. This is not really going right now. Damn it! Frickin' stun my guy. ...39% chance to disarm. Not even a bother. That did not go well. Pushing him back doesn't really accomplish much because he's going to just jump. Well, if I push him back, he can only attack once, so that does have some value. Yeah. Definitely got a little bit lucky there. Got the orc chained. That's huge. These other weapons, you know, I could actually give this to the wild man. He has so much fatigue. We didn't get the orc cleaver, though. See where he's at in terms of fatigue. 60 fatigue with an orc flail. Could just give him this weapon for the length of the campaign. I think I'm gonna do that. Because he doesn't really have enough fatigue to use some of the other weapons I might want him to use, like a hammer, or he could use a two-handed mace, but I'd rather use a flail. I'd rather use this weapon than a two-handed mace. He just doesn't have enough fatigue. So I think for now, Let's give him adrenaline first. Maybe our wild man we can just use this axe with. This is a good weapon too. All right, we need to finish this contract now. Here are the orcs. I was wondering where they were. Let's go try and fight the orcs. They just fought whatever's here at this fortress and died. Let's see what's here. All right, I guess the orcs took over this camp. Trying to see what's here, but they're not really coming out. We're gonna have to retreat. Our guys just don't have enough armor. What is this guy up? Six turns? I mean, this fight is kind of like we could maybe barely win the fight, but look at how many of our guys are in like 30 helmets. I mean, that's just, it's very little margin for error in that situation. That's it. That's our flagellant who has 39 HP. Alright, this is a good fight for us. A few marksmen, some raiders. We do have to be careful. These guys in the back line, they got 30s. They could take a lot of damage off these marksmen. This is kind of what we need to do now, is fight raiders. Looks like all the raiders are happy to just sit back and throw. Leave these guys kind of in the back for now, since they don't get too banged up. I'm gonna put him back here. He should be okay there. I was like, okay, yeah, why can't he do anything? Because he took an oath. I forgot about the oath. Let's save his stam. This guy's not a threat to us. So I'd like to farm these guys, but we need to focus on just winning the fight right now. I'd like to move up with this guy, but he's pretty weak. Change my mind. Because I think I'm going to move him here and then adrenaline. Kill. Can't get too aggressive with this guy, he's too weak. Maybe we can farm these raiders. He's got a helmet, he's got an 80. Not the best. Breaking. I'm gonna have to kill this guy. He's too dangerous with this flail. This guy can try and tie up the archers. So hopefully we can grab this guy's helmet. That would be a nice pickup. Seeing if there was any knives on the ground. This guy has a knife. Good. Got the helmet. That's what, really what we need is good helmets now. Need some pole arms too. I mean, there's a lot of things we could do with this guy. I like having him as this kind of wild card that we has just like adrenaline with a crazy strong weapon. Problem is, he's only got 65 attack. If we gave him a shield, it's not bad. Yeah, I think I'm gonna give him axe mastery because I actually like one-handed axes. It's just hard to ever find anybody that we can use it with. So let's give him the heater shield. I think we're doing pretty well. We need more better recruits and better armor. So that's what we're going to have to focus on, is fighting raiders and farming raiders. $390 for a militia. Let's see what they have for sale. Let's try the militia for $390. He's better than some of the other guys that we have that are trash. I'm gonna give him a C. Thought we had a guy that was triple F. Let's get rid of this guy now. We need better pole arms, too. Hopefully we can farm at least one or two of these raiders. That would be a good outcome for us. This guy doesn't have a shield. These guys are pretty strong. This is not an easy fight. I'm waiting for this guy to throw before I move in our flail guy. Perfect. That's what I wanted. This guy to come out, overextend. Because he's dangerous, and this guy's dangerous. If we can kill them two, we should be fine. I'm gonna wait. This guy's gonna come in here. So I'm gonna wait with him. This guy would be a good candidate to farm. Him and him. So I'm gonna try and do that. Fling. dude. Got a heater shield, man. I needed this guy to tank him, but he's failing at his job right now. He's breaking though, so we should be okay. Probably. Get the surround on this guy so we can get him to flee. Maybe. Okay, he's fleeing, so that's what we're looking for. Thank you. It's never easy. All right. We got exactly what we needed, though. We got a pike, which is exactly what we needed. Two sets of armor and two helmets. That was perfect. Just need a few more of those fights, and we should have a full set of armor for our guys. You know, we could either make this guy like a crappy front, or we could put him in the back and give him quick hands with adrenaline. And he could actually be decent in that role because he has a talent in melee attack. So I think I'm going to do that. Let's start off by giving him adrenaline. And we can give him the pike. This guy's not a C at this point, because he's leveling really shittily. Got one melee defense at level 3. It's horrible. 36 resolve is terrible. But we're going to move him into the front. He's a shitty frontliner. Okay, our thief. Looks like he can be another crappy kind of frontliner. Guy who uses a sword and a shield at some point. Can move him into the front now. Let's give this guy an arming sword as a backup weapon. It was a good fight. Your men do not heal injuries. That's just stupid. 15% less experience. Obviously that sucks. No experience for allied kills. I'm not sure which is going to give us less experience. But at least this one gives us some resolve and fatigue recovery. So, I think we'll just take that one. Let's take a look and see what it is. Ten raiders. Okay, that's what I was looking for. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Certainly not an easy fight, but I don't want to give up. Because we need good armor, and this is a good opportunity to get some. you know, I could move him here, adrenaline, and then attack this guy, which would be strong, but then this guy with the mace would be able to hit him. Can't allow that to happen. I could also move him over here so he could attack this guy, who's pretty strong. He's got a military cleaver, a lot of armor. So I think that's probably a better move for him. Okay, perfect. This guy completely overcommitted. I didn't want this guy to be able to sit back and throw. I'm trying to think of where Halston is going to go. I want him to come over here. If I move this guy here, well, this guy's going to act first. When is this guy up? 12 turns. I think he'll be okay over there. Okay, you wait. Fifty % chance to hit. I'm not gonna adrenaline right now. This guy wants to throw, huh? I'm gonna leave this guy here. Good shot. Okay, that's what we wanted. Now we can come in and whack him with the mace. Come on, dude. 68, man. Anton might be in trouble now. He doesn't have a lot of armor, Anton. What is this guy doing? Come on, dude, stop missing. Yeah. Looks like our best guy is gonna get killed now. Look at that. If we just hit him one time with the mace. Seven turns versus 12. Well, he could easily get killed here. Come on. Who is this guy? It's our crappy Mason. If he gets killed, he gets killed, but that's a good roll for him. This guy can't even attack. He's fleeing now. I missed that. He's fleeing. I would have liked to have farmed this guy, but we're not going to be able to because he could kill Anton. Okay, well, it looks like Anton might be dead anyways. Yeah, Anton is dead. Can't let this guy flee with all this stuff. Yeah. I'm gonna try and farm that this guy right here. Keep trying to farm this guy. Wait, he has shield wall up right now. I mean, you gonna let him get away, dude? Really? This guy is actually gonna let him get away. I can't believe it. This fight really just illustrates how bad our guys are. In case there was any question. Alright, man. We got two guys next to him with knives. We'll see if that's enough. This guy doesn't have a knife. We don't have enough guys up here to block his retreat. Good. He has basically no armor left now. Idiots. This guy. This is the guy that blew it for us. Berthoff. He's got no armor left now. Okay, we can still use him with brain damage. We got lucky. All right. Good fight. I mean, military cleaver is great. I'm not sure if we have anybody that could use it. I'll have to think about that. Two-handed mace is great. A little bit of armor, not as much as I had hoped for. Got a heater shield. So we have two guys named Anton. I just realized that. We don't have enough tools for all that. Let's see if we can find finish this mission here. So we're not going to be taking that fight. You know, our main guy that just went down, he's only got 22 melee defense, so that is risky using a two-handed weapon with only 20-ish melee defense is risky. I do it sometimes if I feel like it's worth it. and I try and be safe with the guy. I mean, he had two clean shots to hit him with the flail at 68% and failed. So if he had just hit him one time, he would have been fine. So most of the time, he'll hit at least once. We need tools. We don't know where there's like any citadels or anything. We need to find citadels. But I'll have to do that another time because I need to stop now. I don't see any roads up here. So they're cold to us, so we can go up there. This place is hostile, but the actual faction is just cold. So I think, before I forget, buy a little bit of food. I'm gonna have to head over here and get tools. I'm gonna do this now before I forget. And then we're gonna have to explore more of the map and try and find citadels and stuff. What was this fight? We don't know what it is, but we don't have any tools, so. Maybe we can come back there. Weissenhaven? Okay. I'm not gonna do it right now. I'm gonna head this way. So we need medical supplies as well. Just gonna get our guys ready for this fight. We need more pole arms. I'm gonna have to stop there. Make sure to please subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.